Victor and Vincent Trevino. With great joy, it's made my claim for you, Jesus Christ, our Savior, by the sign of his cross. I trace the cross on your forehead, and I invite your parents and godparents to do the same. Almighty and ever living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast
And he sent messengers ahead of him. On the way, they entered a Samaritan village to prepare for his reception there. But they would not welcome him, because the destination of his journey was Jerusalem. When the disciples, James and John, saw this, they asked, "Lord, do you want us to call down fire from heaven to consume them?" Jesus turned and rebuked them, and they journeyed to another village. As they were proceeding on their journey, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." Jesus answered him, "Foxes have dens, and the birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to rest his head." And to another he said,
we come into a key section in the loop in the Gospel of Luke today. Because up to this time, Jesus was ministering to many, many people, and he was ministering with them in Galilee, where he was born, where he grew up. But now, there's a switch. And Jesus resolutely is taking his disciples to Jerusalem. It's a journey to Jerusalem. And Jerusalem is a change. A change in Jesus' life. Because he realizes that he will be suffering, that he will die in Jerusalem. And what will happen here? Journey is something that is with us in our life. We hear it many times. We hear about a journey. Usually it's the beginning, the middle, and the end of our life. But for us as Christians, as followers of Jesus Christ, we are on a pilgrimage, and we have an end in mind. And as we walk this pilgrimage with our focus, our end, what we are looking for in our life, Jesus Christ in mind, we pray along the way. We support one another in the challenges and the crises that come into our life. We're there. We're there for one another. Jesus Christ is in the mind's eye, and Jesus Christ is before us all the time. And the challenge for us as disciples of Jesus Christ today is to listen to the word of Jesus Christ, and how to translate, to bring, to live that world and to see that the responsibilities that we have are good. And it is for us to keep our mind and focus on Jesus Christ and to do the responsibilities, the work, the important things that we have in our life every day. But Jesus Christ is with us continually, is before us in our mind. Our responsibilities do not get in the way of what we do, but when we face every day, our work, our ordinary everyday life is the way to Jesus Christ. It's the way to our privilege, to our end. We see man calls in the readings today. We see a vision and a cloak was put over his back, his call, as he was plowing the field. We see Peter in his call. The call came to him while he was washing the net. The call came to Matthew as he was in the tax booth, collecting taxes. Jesus all came to him. Moses, as he was tending sheep in the field, the call came to him. And we recognize and we see that the call came to these people in a dramatic way in their everyday life. And the call of Jesus Christ to us may not be as dramatic as it was for Elisha and Peter and Matthew and Moses, but the call comes to us in our everyday ordinary life, in our responsibilities, in the things that we do. And we may be called. We may be called to simplify our lives. We may be called to cut back on our schedule, on our busyness, on our time, so that we have more time to spend with our family, with our wife, our husband. We may be called to get out of a relationship that is abusive. We may be called to get out of a game or friends that they're pulling us down and not really building us up and bringing Jesus Christ or bringing us closer to Jesus Christ in our prayer. Victor Vincent, you are God's work of art, created in Jesus Christ. You have been called by the Lord to walk as children in the light. Blessed be our God who chooses you in the light of Christ. God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you from sin and given you a new birth. Victor Vincent Trevino welcomes you into his holy keep. He now anoints you with the prism of salvation. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, may you live always as a member of his body, sharing the everlasting life. This is Vincent and Victor Trevino, you have become a new creation. Clothe yourself in Christ. See in this white garment your outward sign of Christian dignity. With your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting light of heaven. Victor and Vincent Trevino, you have become a new creation. Clothe yourself in Christ. See, receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning bright. Each year on this day, take off this candle and light it with Vincent and Victor to remind them of this great day. And as they grow older, encourage them to celebrate
justice and freedom, and mutual respect among people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Are you, I'm Emerald's parent, the dad.
Oh, David, each
Mark Pedalis and my wife, Anita.
Markopolis.
Hurry, let's run.
It's the Markosaurus. He's carrying a shopping basket.
Oh no, okay,
what's
that? He changes
everything. Hello. Hey guys. Alright, I'm stopping it already.
And so the days of the samurai had ended. Nations, like men, sometimes said, have their own destiny. As for the Americans,